Chapter 5, Neuro. This will be the first of three videos focused on different classes of antidepressants. This video will focus on the four different classes of antidepressants that we see in practice and how they work. So depression is thought to be due to a decreased amount of neurotransmitters in the brain, especially serotonin, which we think of as a feel-good neurotransmitter, or other things like norepinephrine and dopamine. So it's thought that by increasing the levels of these neurotransmitters, we can then in turn enhance our mood and improve our depression. So here is just a list of the four classes that we will review today. So the first class is selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs. And the example we will be looking at today is fluoxetine or Prozac. And this drug just works to inhibit the breakdown of serotonin within the neurons to therefore increase the level of serotonin in the brain. So the next class is serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors, or SNRIs. And now this isn't to be confused with SSRIs. In SSRI, the first S stands for selective, and for SNRIs, the S does not stand for selective, it stands for serotonin. So SNRIs work to inhibit the breakdown of both serotonin and norepinephrine. So the example we'll work with today is venlafaxine, or the brand name Effexor. The next class is tricyclic antidepressants, or TCAs. They work the same way that SNRIs work, by inhibiting the reuptake of serotonin and norepinephrine, but they're named after their shape, which is the three-ring structure that we see with tricyclic. And monoamine oxidase inhibitors, those are the MAOIs, and the example we'll use today is the isocarboxazide, or the Marplan. They work on monoamine oxidase, which is an enzyme in the brain that breaks down neurotransmitters like serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. So if we inhibit this enzyme, we increase the levels of those neurotransmitters to treat depression. So let's look at an example. So question one will be a select all that apply. So an antidepressant that works on serotonin and norepinephrine is... And so we have the SSRI, SNRI, TCA, and MAOI. So the correct answer is B, C, and D. So SNRIs, like we said before, work on both serotonin and norepinephrine, and so do TCAs like amitriptyline, and the MAOI also works on dopamine. The selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors like fluoxetine, they work on serotonin only. Okay, so the next question. So it's an antidepressant that works on serotonin and norepinephrine and is named after its shape is, and again, we have the same four options for our answer. And so the correct answer is C, amitriptyline. That one works on both serotonin and norepinephrine and is named after its shape, which has the three cyclic rings. A is incorrect because it only works on serotonin. B, venlafaxine is incorrect. It does work on serotonin and norepinephrine, but it's not named after its shape. And then D, isocarboxazide, is incorrect because it works on the monoamine oxidase enzyme. So now the next couple questions, we'll change the question to make each of the answers correct. So an antidepressant that works only on serotonin, the correct answer is A, fluoxetine. That one is selective for serotonin, as the name implies. B and C are incorrect because they work on serotonin and norepinephrine both. And then isocarboxazide works a little differently, as it blocks that monoamine oxidase enzyme, which then in turn causes it to work on serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. Okay, so now we're going to make B correct. So an antidepressant that is an SNRI is B, venlafaxine. As we reviewed before, fluoxetine is an SSRI, only inhibiting serotonin. Amitriptyline does work in the same way that SNRIs do, but they're named after their shape. And isocarboxazide is an MAOI. Okay, so now we'll make D correct. So an antidepressant that prevents the breakdown of neurotransmitters is D, isocarboxazide. A, B, and C are incorrect because those are all reuptake inhibitors, so they just prevent the breakdown of the neurotransmitters, but the isocarboxazide works by inhibiting monoamine oxidase, which usually breaks down neurotransmitters. So by inhibiting the effect of the monoamine oxidase enzyme, we are able to then in turn increase levels of neurotransmitters like serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine.